At the end of the last video, we divided groups up into net electron withdrawing and net electron donating groups. In this video, we're going to refine this distinction a little bit more and develop a continuum that runs all the way from strongly donating to strongly withdrawing, and learn the factors that play into the relative strengths of donating and withdrawing groups. We're also going to look at how empirical measurements were used to provide an empirical or observational foundation for these intuitive ideas about molecular structure that we've been developing so far. One point we made way back in our first examination of the effects of donating and withdrawing groups is that these affect the electron density within the ring. Any sort of reaction then that involves the electrons within the ring will be affected by a change in substituent. More specifically, we should be able to see changes in equilibrium constants, capital K values, and rate constants, lowercase k values, for reactions involving the benzene ring. And a number, a measured number, called the Hammett constant for a substituent captures the dependence of either the equilibrium constant or the rate constant for a particular reaction on the nature of the substituent. A number of different reactions have been used for this purpose over the years, but the one we're going to focus on is the simplest one, and one of the first ones, involving the deprotonation of benzoic carboxylic acids, like this. This is simply a proton transfer reaction where the proton associated with the carboxylic acid functional group is transferred to water, generating a carboxylate anion, an H3O+. This has an equilibrium constant, which we're going to call K sub R, since what we're varying here is the R group located para to the carboxylic acid functional group. And the Hammett constant, sigma P, where the P here just refers to the fact that the substituent is para, in the para position, relative to the carboxylic acid function group, is defined as the logarithm of the ratio of the equilibrium constant for this reaction when the substituent R is used here, divided by the equilibrium constant for this reaction when the substituent is simply hydrogen. The logarithm is used because subtle changes in R will cause exponential changes in the equilibrium constant, and using the logarithm here makes this value proportional to free energy. And so not only does it have some thermodynamic meaning in that sense, but it's much more human-friendly since we won't be dealing with exponents. Now let's think about how donating and withdrawing groups will affect the value of K sub R here. Donating groups are going to tend to destabilize the anion, since they'll be shoving electron density into the ring, which is already electron-rich due to this negatively charged carboxylate anion group. This will tend to push this reaction back toward reactants, making K sub R smaller and making the logarithm of K sub R divided by K sub H less than zero. In other words, sigma P will be less than zero for a donating R group. Withdrawing R groups, on the other hand, will tend to stabilize the carboxylate anion since they'll introduce more partial positive charge into the ring, which helps with delocalization of the negative charge of the carboxylate anion. This electron withdrawal effect will tend to push this reaction toward products relative to the case where the substituent is hydrogen, making K sub R greater than K sub H in this case. And the logarithm of K sub R over K sub H, also known as sigma P, positive. To help clarify the meaning of sigma P, let's lay down some important types of substituents on our continuum from electron-rich and electron-poor and look at their sigma P values. By convention, hydrogen is defined as right in the middle of this scale. For hydrogen, the sigma P is equal to zero, since the ratio of K sub H to K sub H must be one and its logarithm must be zero. Strongly electron-withdrawing substituents, strong electron-withdrawing groups, are going to have sigma P values that are much, much greater than zero due to their strong stabilization of the negative charge. These will be things, for example, like the NO2 group, the nitro group. On the other hand, strongly electron-donating substituents are going to be associated with highly negative sigma P values. These would be things, for example, like the amino group, which is strongly electron-donating. What the Hammett constant or sigma value gives us is a quantitative measure based on empirical measurements of an equilibrium constant of the electron donating or withdrawing power of a substituent. The more positive sigma is, the more strongly withdrawing the substituent is, and the more negative sigma is, the more strongly donating the substituent is. And the beauty of this number is that it combines resonance and inductive effects. Since it's an empirical measurement, it makes no distinction between resonance and inductive effects. Let's survey some typical values of Hammett constants for different substituents that we've seen. In doing this, we want to rationalize the relative values of the Hammett constants by looking at the structures of the substituents, and this isn't as complicated as it sounds. The two big factors to take a look at are the electronegativity of the atom connected to the benzene ring and any resonance possibilities within the R group. You'll see what I mean when we look at examples. So here I've listed some electron donating groups. From most strongly donating at the top, notice the highly negative value of sigma p at the top of this list, to least electron donating at the bottom. At the top of this list, notice that we find the least electronegative atoms in Me2, NH2, and O-, which with the negative charge is going to be much, much less electronegative than a neutral oxygen atom. As the electronegativity of the atom connected to benzene increases, the electron donating power tends to decrease, with neutral oxygen being considerably lower than neutral nitrogen in general on this scale. An interesting exception is this group here, which is the amide functional group. While the amide is electron donating overall, it's not as strongly donating as a plain vanilla amine, because the lone pair that would be donated to the aromatic pi system is also participating in what we might think of as competitive resonance involving the carbonyl group. Because that lone pair is being pulled on by two electron withdrawing groups, each electron withdrawing group gets, in a rough sense, about half as much of the electron density. And so this nitrogen is not as strongly donating as a nitrogen that lacks that additional withdrawing group, such as the nitrogen in NME2 or in NH2. We see the same effect happening for oxygen, in fact, with OME being a stronger electron donor than OCONE, which is an ester containing a carbonyl group that's tugging on the oxygen's lone pair, pulling it away from the aromatic pi system. Here's a survey of some electron withdrawing groups, with the most strongly electron withdrawing at the bottom and the least strongly withdrawing at the top. We can notice even here that as the electronegativity of the atom connected to the aromatic ring increases, in general, the value of sigma p increases. The electron withdrawing power goes up. The halogens are an exception to that idea only because they're donating by resonance, which compensates for their inductive withdrawing effect. Roughly speaking here, we can make a distinction between weakly withdrawing substituents, which are essentially the halogens, and that's it, moderately withdrawing substituents, which have sigma p values between about 0.35 to, let's say, 0.55, and the strongly withdrawing substituents, which are going to have sigma p values in excess of 0.55. We can do the same thing on the donating side, and just as a rough cutoff, the strongly donating substituents are amines and O-. Moderately donating substituents is pretty much any heteroatom, and then your weakly donating substituents are going to be the ester, which is this uniquely deactivated oxygen, and any alkyl substituents with relatively low sigma p values. Ultimately, the exact positions of groups within these tables isn't terribly important to understand. Instead, the most important thing is to recognize the roles of electronegativity and resonance within the R group in the strengths of electron donating and withdrawing groups. We can make educated guesses about the relative electron donating or withdrawing power of two substituents by thinking about these two structural factors.